We'll split all utilities. We'll split rent.
Yep.
Who's paying the bills? Are you paying the bills or am I paying the bills?
What do you think?
I think I'm financially more literate than you are.
Couples fight about money more than anything else. So I built a budget spreadsheet in Google Sheets that actually helps you end those arguments. And in this video, I'll show you exactly how it works step by step. By the end, you'll see how you and your partner can use this one sheet to finally get on the same page financially. And stick with me until the end because I'll walk you through a real example couple who went from constant stress over who's paying for what to figuring out how to split things fairly and no more arguments. All right, let's start with income. So under partner one and partner two, you both just enter your take-home pay. That's after taxes and deductions, the actual money hitting your bank account. Let's walk through an example. Partner one takes home $4,000 per month. I'll type that in here. And partner two makes $2,000. This is a combined household income of $6,000 per month. Now that you know what's coming in, the next question is always who pays what? This section is for your household expenses. Fixed expenses are bills that don't change much month over month, like rent, mortgage, utilities, internet, subscriptions. And since this section is for household, you list all the stuff you both use in this table. Now here's where the arguments actually start. How do you split it? Do you go 50-50? Do you split based on income? Or does one person pay more because they make more? I built four different options into the sheet so you don't have to fight about it. Comment down below what budget split you think is the best. Let's start with the most common 50-50. Let's say rent is $3,000. You enter the amount and the sheet automatically splits it, $1,500 each. Electricity, let's say $200, so that's $100 each. Internet, $80 becomes $40 each. You get the picture here. You don't even touch a calculator, the sheet just tells you the numbers. Now let's say you want it more fair based on income. That's the proportional option. If, for example, partner one makes $4,000, partner two makes $2,000, that's 66% and 33% of the total. If you switch the dropdown to proportional, rent at $3,000 gets split $2,000 for partner one and $1,000 for partner two. That way, the higher earner carries a little more of the load. Some couples prefer a more dramatic split. That's where the 75/25 options come in. Maybe partner one is the higher earner. And they want to cover 75%. In that case, rent becomes $2,250 for them and $750 for the partner. Or flip it, 25-75, if partner two is the higher earner. The point is, no matter what philosophy you use, the sheet adjusts automatically. And if you think these numbers are unrealistic, stick around because I'm going to show you a real example budget from a couple who are still trying to figure out how to split things fairly. Okay, fixed bills are handled. Now comes the trickier part, daily spending. This is where most couples fight because it feels random. Who bought groceries last? Who paid for gas? Who Venmo'd for takeout? Here's how this section works. First, you pick the month. Right now it's showing October, but you can click the dropdown and select any month. When I choose October, the sheet automatically generates all 31 days of the month in the daily spending log. Now let's talk about balances. Each partner gets their own balance. Balance is equal to your income minus your share of household expenses. So if partner one made $4,000 and their share of bills was $2,500, they have $1,500 left to spend for the month. Same thing for partner two. If they make $2,000 and their share of bills was $1,250, they're left to spend is $750. Now watch what happens as spending gets logged. Let's say partner one goes grocery shopping and spends $100. They enter it under their column for that day. Their balance drops from $1,500 to $1,400. Partner two's balance doesn't change because it wasn't their purchase. Then a few days later, partner two fills the gas tank, let's say $50. They enter it and their balance goes from $750 to $700. Partner one's balance stays the same. Over time, you both see your balances going down, but the goal is simple. Keep your number above zero by the end of the month, or put it into savings or investments. Now, here's an example of overspending. Let's say partner one has a bad habit of eating out too often, and by the 20th of the month, their balance drops below zero. That's a clear signal to make some changes and go out less. Partner two might still have $500 left, but that's their balance, not part of the household expenses. The sheet makes this visible, and this is where a lot of couples finally start feeling like they're on the same team again. Now, let me show you what this looks like in real life. I found this post on Reddit of a couple. She's 29, making $3,300 per month, and he is 33, making $2,800 per month. They've been together for 6 years, The problem they are facing is the only debt she has is a car loan, but her partner has quite a lot of it, student loans and credit card debt. So splitting 50-50 for their debts might not make sense here. Drop a comment if you would split student loans 50-50 with your partner. So let's enter their incomes into the sheet and we'll make her partner one and him partner two. Then let's try a 50-50 split. Let's enter all their household expenses, not including debt. We'll instead put that later over in the daily spending tracker. The post didn't include household expenses, so I'll enter some examples here. So far with a 50-50 split, they each pay $1,500 in household expenses. That leaves partner one with a balance of $1,800 left over to spend for the month, and him, partner two, $1,300 left to spend for the month. Next, they log their daily spending. First, we'll enter the due dates of the debt payments for each of them. Let's say her car loan is due on the 5th, and it's $200 per month. Then for him, partner two, he has student loans, let's say $300 per month, and credit card debt, $250 per month. Now their remaining balances are $1,600 and $750, and they are free to spend the rest of it however they want. Instead of arguing about you spent too much on restaurants, they both agreed ahead of time. As long as your own debts are covered, you're free to do whatever you each want with your leftover balances. That's what this sheet gives couples, a system, a way to end the money fights and actually feel like you're working together. So that's a budget spreadsheet I made for couples, income, expenses, daily spending, and leftover balances, all in one place, designed to take arguments off the table. If you want to try it out, the link is below in the description. And if you found this helpful, I've made a whole library of templates for individuals, families, even side hustles. Check those out too. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.